I will not stop until I prevail. Make that your prayer tonight. I will not stop. I know it's turbulent. The volcano has come to distract. The tempest has come to isolate. But in order for the books to be open, a man must prevail. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat upon the throne a book written within and on the backside, sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof?" No man in heaven, nor on earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open the book and to read the book, neither to look thereon. One of the elders said unto me, "Weep not. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, had prevailed." He has prevailed. In order for a man to open the book of the testament of your family and isolate the anointing, the oil that was supposed to drive that family into destiny, a man must prevail. I will not stop until I prevail. Make that your prayer tonight. I will not stop. I know it's turbulent. The volcano has come to distract. The tempest has come to isolate. But in order for the books to be open, a man must prevail. Father, we are that generation that have become restless. The yoke upon our shoulders must be broken. Weep not. For the Lion of the tribe of Judah, of the root of David, he has prevailed. He has prevailed.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name.
And there were seven sons of one Sceva, a Jew and chief of the priest, which did so. And the evil spirit answered and said, "Jesus, I know. And Paul, I know, but who are ye?" That means even the devil has a record of prevailing people in his archive. "Jesus, I know, he prevailed. Paul, I know, your name is not on the list." "You don't have authority to operate in these parts. We have not heard of you." "Jesus, I know, Paul, I know." We will not stop until the devil knows we came to. Until hell is aware that we have made an appearance. And the man in whom this evil spirit was leaped upon them and overcame them and prevailed against. Because the guys had no identity in the spirit, the demon spirit did what? It's as if the battle in the realm is to secure the prevailing dominion. He prevailed against them. He didn't leave them the same. He beat them and left them naked and wounded. Now, you see, this was an event that took place in Ephesus. Ephesus was the land of idolatry. There were all kinds of altars raised in the name of different kinds of spirit. This was the land that Paul entered and called them a bunch of superstitious people. In fact, they had an altar erected to a God that was an unknown God. Just in case we miss the list, just in case there's one left out, let's erect. Now, it was in the same land of idolatry where Paul passed by, and it was that place where the sons of Sceva tried to cast out devils. All right, are you with me? Now, on the account of what happened, they saw demons speak and identify that we know Jesus. Demons spoke and said, we know Paul. When the people heard it, guess what happened? And this was known in all among all the Jews and to the Greeks dwelling in Ephesus. And fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord Jesus was magnified. And many believed and confessed and showed their deeds. I'm talking about this man trying to cast out devils. He did not prevail. The demon spoke and gave credence to Jesus and Paul. People heard it. The news spread. And it was not a miracle that took place. It was the testimony that came from the demonic realm that came into the city. And fear came upon the entire land. I mean, a city of idolatrous people. Alright. It was so much that the wind of God seized the place. The conviction of the Holy Ghost seized the place. So much that the Bible revealed that many that use curious books. Many also which use curious arts brought their books together. I'm talking of diviners and necromancers, enchanters that had books in their archives that they consulted in order to bring or put together the accurate alignment of sorcery, of divination, of necromancy. They gathered their stock and they burnt them. And the Bible says, so mighty grew the word of God that it what? So mightily grew the word of God that it prevailed. Now, if at any point in time you get to forget what God has told you, the word that he has given you, you are not worthy to stand before him. Because you cannot understand the manifestation of the Spirit of God until you understand the manifestation of the word of God. How does the word of God manifest? And so the Bible says, in that city, the mightily grew the word of God that it prevailed. Can we pray for Nigeria and say, God, there's so much preaching around, but let the word of the kingdom grow mightily and prevail and conquer. Let it conquer the principality of the occult that has besieged our nation. Let it conquer the principality of corruption that has crippled our destiny as a corporate people, outlined and bedeviled by prophecy, a people favored by God, crippled by the enemy. Let the word of God and his counsel prevail among us as a nation, as a people, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let that great counsel prevail. Let the word of God, the voice of God prevail in Nigeria. Let it prevail against the power of the occult. Let it prevail against divination. Let it prevail against enchantment. Let the newborn destiny of this nation, of this land, rise out of obscurity. Let the hand of God conquer that which seeks to manipulate the soul of our nation and to compromise the stature of our corporate persona. Father, we call upon you today. We give you praise. We give you glory. We honor you.
In Jesus' name.